Welcome to the introductory mathematics for AI. In this fifth week, we will cover the orthogonal projection and least squares problem. We will cover four sections, least square problems and meaning of the least square problem, and orthogonal projection and the least square solution, and curve fitting. This least square method must be the most intuitive way to obtain the best fit curve representing the data patterns. Okay. Let's find out how we can get the best possible solution using the method of least squares. We will preview the section on the web page with practice. Then we will go through the whole content. Then we will preview. And we will review what we've been through in week 5. And this web address, week 5, we will study least square problems. We will find out the best fit on the given data, best fitting lines like this. In here, we will set up a linear system of equations and we find the best possible solution by minimizing the error between AX and Y. In section 2, the meaning of the least square problems, we will analyze the method of minimizing this error, which is this norm of A minus AU minus Y will be the error that we're gonna minimize. Okay. And those ideas comes from the projection, the concept of projection. Finding T that satisfying this minimization problem is just about finding the projection of this vector onto this vector A. And we will learn how to find this T, which is a projection is equal to TA. And the code will be introduced to find the projection. And we will generalize the concept to the three-dimensional space. We want to find the projection of Y onto this plane, which has a two-dimensional plane. We're going to find the projection of Y onto this plane. And this can be done by finding this type of linear system of equation to have the least square solution like this. And as you see, this least square solution can be obtained by multiplying the inverse of A transpose A times A transpose times Y. So if we do, then we will find those least square solution. We will explain how those code was made. Then in the last section, curve fitting, we will generalize those idea to find the best fit curve. For example, we have a 4-point, then we will find not only a line, then we will be able to find the best fit curve. In this case, if we want to have a second degree polynomial that fits best fit this 4-point, then we will set up this linear system of equation. Then this will give us the least square solution that minimizes this era, which is very similar to what we did. Then we will have open problems. Okay, now we're going to start those. Here. For example, we have a 4 point in XY plane. Then we want to find the best fit line. This. We call this is the least square line or the best fit line on these 4 points. Let's consider the simplest way of solving the best possible straight line, y equal a plus bx. Suppose those 4 points pass through this point, then it should satisfy this equation. So when x is equal to 1, 0, then y should be 1. When x is equal to 1, then y should be 3. And when x is equal to 2, y is 4. When x is equal to 3, y is equal to 4, like this. Then we can form a system of linear equations like this, which can be written in this way. Okay. So if we let this one as a matrix A and vector U and vector Y, then we have a linear system of equation A U equal Y. Okay. If this has a unique solution, then there's no problem to solve it. But in most of the case, we may not have a unique solution. Sometimes it may not have any solutions, but still, we want to find the best possible solution. So we try to find an approximated u hat that minimizes the distance between AU and Y. Okay. This problem is called the least square problem. And that approximated solution u hat is called the optimal solution or the least square solution of this. Okay, section 5.2. Then what it means, what that least square problems means. Let a y hat be the value obtained by inputting xi from each data point xi and yi. Then there is an error for some I where yi and yi hat are not the same. Okay. If for all I, those yi and yi hat are equal, then the line y is equal to a plus bx has a unique solution. But there are many cases that this sum where yi is not same as yi hat. In other words, the yi minus yi hat square is not all zero for some I. So we will try to find A and B that minimize the error. Okay. How? We adding all the squared error for the given data gives the following error function E of U. So E of U error can be written as the square for the first point, and second point, third point, and first point. Then it can be written as AU, the square of norm of AU minus Y. We wanna, these are the error of those, four of them. Then we wanna minimize this E of U. This error, E of U, eventually equal to the square of the distance between AU and Y. Okay, solving the least square problem is solving the problem of finding u hat that minimizes this error, E of U. The optimal solution to this problem is the least square solution u hat. In order to find the least square solution, we need the concept of projection. Okay. Projection and the least square solution. to understand the resistive square problem, we need to know that a projection, the concept of projection. The problem of finding T satisfying the following, the minimization of norm of TA minus X, where T is a real number. And this means this is the problem of finding T that minimizes the distance between the vector X and the straight line containing A, where T is the scalar. Like this. X is here, and A is here. We want to find the projection of X onto A. Then, a projection must be scalar multiple of A, which is TA. The projection is the one that which is orthogonal from this point to this vector X. So we want to find the P is equal to TA, where TA meet at this at the, as a, an end po- at the end point. We want to minimize the error. Error between these is bigger than error between this, isn't it? This is the shortest distance of X onto this vector A. So we want to find when you want to minimize this, that's the same problem of finding the projection of X onto A, which is this P. Okay, here. So intuitively, the shortest distance can be obtained when P is equal to TA and X minus TA is perpendicular to A vector. This and this should be perpendicular. X minus TA will give us this. So this vector and A should be perpendicular. So this is the condition for the projection. So such T is the solution for minimization of the norm of TA minus X. So the vector P is equal to TA is called the projection of X onto A. How we can find this T? Because these two vectors are orthogonal, so inner product of those two vectors should be zero. So if we simplify this, then AX is equal to T times A and inner product of A and A, like this. Then T will be isolated as inner product of A and X over inner product of A and A, which can be written as this. A inner product of A and A can be written as A transpose A, and A inner product X can be written A transpose times X. Okay. So T can be found from A and X, which were given. Okay. Easy. Example one asks us to find the projection of Y onto X. So suppose we have two vectors like this, then we wanna set set the vector X and vector Y here, then find the inner product of X and Y and inner product of X and X. Then divide it and then multiply X here. That will give us the projection P. This is the TX, which is parallel to the vector X. Very simple. So whatever vector you do have, we can use this code to do compute this TX. Okay, we can solve the least square problem similar to the higher dimensional vectors. For this purpose, let A1 and A2 be the first and second column vector of the matrix A, respectively. Then we have AU can be written as A times the first column of the matrix A plus B times second column of the matrix A. Mm-hmm. The problem is this. Finding the the solution for minimizing this norm of AU minus Y is the same as find the minimize the A, little a capital and first column of A plus B times second column of A minus B. Okay. If you look at this figure 3, then you will see A1, the first column and second column form a plane, two vector, the column, two columns form a column space, which is a plane. Then we are looking for the projection of Y onto this plane, which is the shortest distance from Y to this plane. So here, this point P projection should be orthogonal to A1 and should be orthogonal to the vector A2. So as you see this problem, this is the length of the marked real line for the values A and B. So it is easy to see that the vector with the shortest distance from Y to this column, this plane, can be obtained by P is equal to A times A1 plus B times A2 when AU minus Y is perpendicular to orthogonal to A1 and AU minus Y is orthogonal to A2. Okay, so does this problem changes to this problem? Okay, given condition, given two conditions, gives us this equations, like you see here, A1, the inner product of first column of A times A and AU minus Y is equal to 0 because they are orthogonal, and A2 and inner product of A2 and AU minus Y is equal to 0. So if you write this in a matrix form, then this is equal to 0 and this first second component is equal to 0. If you write it in a matrix form, then A1 transpose, A2 transpose times AU minus is equal to 2 by 1. A vector like this, and this matrix is the transpose of the first column of A and first column of a second column of A, like this. So we can write this as a transpose. So A transpose times AU minus Y is equal to 0. So this condition, the projection, should satisfy this. So if we expand this, then A transpose AU is equal to A transpose Y. So if A transpose A is invertible, then U can be found. A transpose A inverse times A transpose Y. The least square solution can be found when A transpose A is invertible, which means this is always possible when A has a full column length. Then this is a full length matrix, so it is invertible. So with the minor conditions, it can be done. So this can be done in the most of the case if we choose those Xi's and Xj's are different for a data set, Xi and Yi. Most of data can be chosen when times are different, when time t is equal to x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. So t, the times are different for the most of the data, so Xi's are different. If Xi's are different, then matrix A has a full column length. So A transpose A is always invertible. So A transpose A inverse does exist, and A was given, so A transpose does exist, and Y was given, so multiply Y gives us the least square solution. And this idea is also well related to the Bendelmond matrix and Bendelmond determinant. That anyway, here we use the full column length when this condition satisfies. So for example 2, ask us to find a least square problem of AU is equal to Y. Here, if in table 1, we had a linear system of equation like this. From here, we can see Xi's are here and Y vector. Ones are all here, and x0, x1, x2, x3, x4 are here. These are all different. So these are not the linear combination. So it has this first column and second column are linear independent. If these xi's are all different, then this is always has a full two column rank. So A transpose times A is a 2x2 matrix whose rank is 2, so it's invertible. So U hat, which is A transpose A inverse times A transpose Y, can be obtained. That minimizes the norm of AU minus Y. So AU Y was given, so A transpose A times A transpose times Y gives us this vector. So when you have a matrix A like this, then Y, you can define Y, then least square solution you had can be found the inverse of A transpose A times A transpose times Y, which gives us the same solution, 1.5 and 1 as A and B. So Y is equal to A plus BX, which is 3 over 2 plus X is the best fit line, which means the error between this point to this line, and this point to this line, and this point to this line, this point to this line. So some of those errors are smallest with this line. Okay, we will study a similar process of finding a least square curve or line, which is called in linear regression in when you learn statistics in week 9 and 10. And last, finding a suitable curve for data. We call this a curve fitting. Consider 4 points in xy plane. We have four point data points like this. We want to find the best fit curve, quadratic approximation y is equal to a plus bx plus cx square. Then suppose we want to find the best fit curve of degree 2, then this point should satisfy this. So let's put it in those points on this equation. So when xy is 0, 1, then substitute x is 0 and y is 1. For second point, 1, 3, so 1, 3, so for the point 2, 4, and 2, 4, for the last problem, 3 and 4, then x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 4 like this. Then we have a linear system of equation like this, which can be written as this. Okay. So AU is equal to Y. We have a linear system of equation like this. We want to find the least square solution you had that makes this error between AU and Y is the smallest. Same thing. So error can be written as this plus this plus this plus this. This is the square of the norm of A minus U. Similarly, U hat can be written as A transpose A inverse times A transpose Y, which is this, A, B, C, which can be obtained by defining A and Y vector. Then U star can be found the inverse of A transpose A times A transpose times Y, which has this, 1 and 5 over 2 and minus 1 over 2 as A, B, C. So Y is equal to 1 plus 5 over 2 X minus 1 over 2 X squared. This is the least square curve. We can do the same thing when we have many points and we have a higher degree polynomial that best fit those data points. Similarly, we now can find the cubic and higher approximation for any given endpoint data, endpoint, when xi's are different. Because in that case, the matrix A has a full column rank, so A transpose A invertible, so we can find the least square solution from those equations, those formula that we have found. Suppose we have a 6 points in R2, then we can do the same thing to find the phase speed curve of degree 3. I think that's for the week 5, and we may review review what we did today. Here, you can do practice in here. Yeah. Orthogonal projection and least square problem. Yeah. We want to find the best possible line that fit those given points, and we were able to build up a linear system of equation. A or u is equal to y. We wanted to find approximate solution. Approximate solution you had that minimize the error between a u and y, and it could be done by using the concept of projection. Projection here. Projection of x onto a. Here t could be found. In this, where we learned in the linear algebra in the earlier part, and also those I and when you when you define the vectors and find the inner product, and then this formula gives us the projection like this. Mm-hmm. Okay, this idea can be generalized to in three-dimensional vectors. So when vector y was given in R3, and we are looking for the projection of this y onto this two-dimensional plane, then projection can be found in here, which means it satisfies these two conditions. This gives us this equation, which gives us this equation, which can be found as the same formula that we did use. So this code, if we set up the code, the inverse of A transpose A times A transpose times Y, then this gives us the best possible solutions. Line and curve. For the curve, similar. When you want to find a quadratic function that best fit the given point, then we substitute the given data point to the polynomial, then we will have the linear system of equation that can be written as this. Then we, all we have to do is find this, which can be done with this simple code, which gives us the solution like this. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 5 over 2, and C is equal to minus 1/2. And there was an open problem. Okay. Any question? If you have on lectures on week 5 on least square solution, then feel free to ask it in Q&A. Okay, thanks for your attention.